In this Clash of Clans video, we are going to show you some of the most popular attack strategies in the game right now at Town Hall 11. These attack strategies are trending to help you get the 3 stars, and we will break each one of them down, giving you tips and tricks so that you can copy it and help lead your clan to victory. We have 6 different attack strategies for you, so let's get into it. Alrighty guys, let's dive straight into this, and we're starting off here with the Hog Riders. Now you guys might have seen in the latest sneak peek for the new Clash of Clans update, the Hog Riders are getting upgraded to level 9. Let me know down in the comments what you think of the brand new troop levels, but here at Town Hall 11, we're using more of a traditional method. Now this is most of the time what you will be doing, bringing in a kill squad to take out some key objectives for your Hog Riders. We have a Golem and Wizards on one side, Golem and Wizards on the other. Did get good bounce value with the odd bowler up there, but that allows our heroes to come into the center of the base. Now that is going to allow us to get the Eagle Artillery, but we're also going to lure the Clan Castle troops, take out the enemy queen, take out the enemy king. That is huge value. They are probably the 3 main things you need down, the Clan Castle, king and queen, in terms of a hog attack, because your Hog Riders are not going to fight back. We even managed to get a multi inferno there as well, so fantastic value in terms of this kill squad, and the Hog Riders are already in from the left hand side. If you are new to my channel, be sure to subscribe for all of my Clash of Clans videos, and be sure to turn on that notification bell so you can see them as soon as they go live. Now the Hog Riders, you might have noticed, they came in pretty early. If you can sweep the Hog Riders in front of your kill squad, look at these troops, they're starting to go down, but they've helped to take out more defenses, but they've also helped to take out trash buildings on the inside, namely the Clan Castle, because the Hog Riders are only going to hit the defenses. So notice our cleanup troops at the top of the base here and that of the Wizards. That is basically to make sure you don't run out of time. So be sure, as soon as you've got the Hog Riders in, just start a couple of troops over there where you are going to get to last. So anywhere where the Hog Riders, as you can see, they finish on this side of the base, you want your kill squad on the other so you can pinch in and meet in the middle. But don't forget about any buildings on the inside of the base, like the Clan Castle, like any storages. Be sure to think about maybe taking a miner or minions, anything like that, to take them buildings out as well. Now we have many attacks to show you. This one is the LavaLoon. We have the Dragons. We have the Electro Dragons. Right at the end of the video, we have the PEKKAs. In that of the PEKKA Smash, so many attacks, you don't want to miss them, guys. But into the LavaLoon for this one. We actually had a few different LavaLoon attacks within this war. This is crunch time in our latest just random spin, this one. But if you're interested in joining crunch time to compete at that highest level, or any of the other clans that I cover, be sure to join my Discord server. The link is in the description of this video. You can find out everything you need to know. Now the LavaLoon is very similar in that of the kill squad. Now I've got many videos, in fact I will link one at the end giving you specific tips for LavaLoon, but there's many different ways to come in. For this one, we're actually breaking the queen in towards this area. We've set the funnel on either side for her to come in, and we're mainly using more of a very small kill squad. We're just taking out a couple of objectives, and that is the enemy queen, which is down, and the enemy CC. Now you might notice that the king is still alive. Now that is something which might make you choose the LavaLoon over the Hog Riders on this base, because it's harder to get to the king as well. Whereas the king can attack the Hog Riders, he cannot shoot up towards the balloons. So that is something you might consider. We're just going to let the Grand Warden take that final air defense out. I mean, why not? Then the other thing you need to look at is pathing for LavaLoon. This is again things you need to consider in whether you use Hog Riders or LavaLoon on the back end. Sweepers are both pointing this way. That's perfect. We can come coming right the way around the back of them with the Lalo. And notice how we have good coverage here on the air defenses as well. They're kind of spread out around the base. That allows us to protect our loons very well. So there you are. That makes it ideal for the LavaLoon on the back end. But I've said in a number of my videos, all of these attacks basically use different phases in terms of the kill squad is one phase, the main portion of the attack, the troops you use. Basically, you select the correct phase for the correct base. So even if you take bits of this video to put them into your attack, that's exactly what you want to do. And if you are a specific town hall level, I'm assuming you're town hall 11 if you're watching this video, be sure to check out my homepage because I have playlists of every single town hall level at that higher range, so you can see all of the videos that are relevant for your town hall level. But that is the LavaLoon. Let's move across to the next attack strategy, which is going to be the Miners. The Miners are obviously very strong. They have been at Town Hall 10, 11, and 12, always been one of them popular attack strategies. Often they have been the best attack strategy, but I do enjoy the variety in the game right now. So, the Miners, you're mainly going to want to at Town Hall 11 and 12, once the Eagle Artillery is there, you're mainly going to want to try and take that down because it will crush your Miners very quickly. Don't really have to worry about that at Town Hall 10. Now, the most popular way of getting that is a Queen Charge straight in towards that. So again, we've created a funnel here very simply, funnel here very simply, and now that we have the walls open, there is nowhere for the Queen to go other than into the base, and bing, she's right onto that Eagle Artillery, down it goes, and she's going to carve out a section of the base here as well, which is exactly what you want to do with the Miners. So she is going to take the Clan Castle troops down here. Obviously a dragon is very important. The Miners, it all depends on what's in the Clan Castle. As a best case scenario, the LavaLoon in the Clan Castle is easy because the Lava Hound is not going to shoot the Miners. But anything else, if it can take out the Miners, then you need to be thinking about taking that out. If it's an air-based troop, for instance the Dragon, the Miners aren't really going to do very well. So again, look at what we've actually taken out here. The Queen has taken out this corner of the base, so we don't have to worry about that. The Miners aren't going to be affected from that area, and in they come towards this bottom section. We've created a bit of a funnel on the outside with the King, and the healers swap across onto the Miners. Now, that's not necessarily something which you need. If you can keep your Queen alive so that she continues to take out defenses, continues to protect for the Miners, then you probably want to try and do that. But it's not all lost. I've said this in a few of my videos. Your Queen Charge is all about the value that she can get initially. It's not a necessity, should we say, to keep her alive. You don't have to, although granted, if you can, it is beneficial. Now again, with the Miners, similar to the Hog Riders, the heal spells will be your best friend. The Miners do an incredible amount of damage when they are packed together, but they will get wiped out pretty easily, especially to splash damage. So the heal spells are what you need, but again, if there is an area, let's say, with a lot of high HP buildings and there's a lot of damage, you might pop a rage spell in there in order to press the Miners through very quickly. But Shamwise on this one has more than enough Miners left over to finish off the raid, and that brings us to the end of this strategy, and let's move on to the next one. We are going to now feature the Dragons, followed by the Electro Dragons, before we move on to that Pekka attack strategy to finish off the video. Now the Dragons, Will here does a fantastic job, and the main way, or the most popular way to use it at the moment, is with the DragBat attack strategy. It's very simple in, I don't want to make it sound simple, you don't want to overcomplicate it is what I want to say here, because actually it can be very technical. King on one side, Queen on the other to create the funnel up here. That is a terrible drawing on the screen, but hopefully you get the idea, guys, with the Dragons then pushing through because we've created the funnel. We've narrowed the path here that the Dragons have to come through, and if you can keep out of the way of the sweepers, it is ideal, but it's not always something which you can do. The main thing is using the bats in an appropriate area. So in they come towards this area. We actually have a golem tanking over at that side, which is interesting. Whether you choose to use a hound or the golem in order to help out there, something to help tank for the bats as they come through. And look at it, if you can get them to swoop in at the same time as the dragons, they go hand in hand. And wow, from what looked like the raid was going to go south as the dragons were moving through, all of a sudden all of them spells are used, and boom, before you know it, look at that, the base is crushed and we have so many dragons left over. Will making that one look easy. You do have to think about pathing as well though. The dragons can be a little bit slow. You are going to be speeding that process up once you use the bat spells, but you've got to think, can you keep them bat spells alive? Are you just using them to take out a section of the base? I do have a Town Hall 10 video breaking this down in terms of myself, so be sure to check out my Town Hall 10 play list if you're interested in seeing that. A lot of the skills are exactly the same. E-Dragons. I used to be a huge fan of the E-Dragons. Let me know down in the comments if you use the Electro Dragons and your best tip. If you had to give me one tip for the Electro Dragons, drop it down below and we'll see how many different tips we have. But essentially, if you can chain through the buildings, if you can set the funnel for them, you're going to end up doing very well. Now, this is the attack we teased at the start, and I love the patience of this attack, I've got to say. So the queen takes out an air defense at the top, just one Electro Dragon, just to help create that funnel and allow the main pack of dragons to come straight through towards that eagle. Look at that, before you know it, all of them buildings have gone down, and although that one Electro Drag is now more of a sacrificial dragon, it means that the main bulk of them get pinned into the center of the base, and there are some high HP buildings here that they can chain through. And anytime you can chain onto the higher level buildings, it just means that you might get one more extra chain through in order to them other defenses. And look at how far they come through here. A couple of key tips that I have learned from using the E-Drags. Do not put your rage spells too far ahead of the E-Drags. You can very easily miss. Try and put them right on top of the E-Drags for the best benefit. The freeze spells is something you will need. If you're flying straight into a sweeper, you're going to need that freeze spell, but also single target infernos. Obviously, you need to either freeze them or attack bases with multis, but wow, that attack was epic in my opinion. Again, let me know that tip down in the comments. By the way guys, if you enjoy this video, be sure to leave a like because it does help out massively. But finishing off here, saving the best till last in terms of that PEKKA attack strategy, Celtic coming in here. Now, a lot of you will see a lot of variations of this strategy, whether you use the PEKKAs and split them up in order to kind of tank for your Bow Witch and come in, whether you send them in together. It works very well with the bowlers, and you're basically mixing PEKKAs and bowlers together, and you get a fantastic mix. A lot of the time you will do this alongside a Queen Walk, which then comes into the base behind the PEKKAs and the bowlers. Now I really like how the funnel is set up here, using that haste along with the loons to get in and take that wizard tower, allowing the baby drag to help take out some of these buildings in order to create this funnel here, which wasn't an easy funnel. So I do like how that was created to send the queen down, and then we will be coming in alongside them other troops. You can almost see this natural path here, which we are going to take through the base. You can see we only have one jump spell, so if we zoom out, if you were to go from one end of the base to the other, where are you going to use that? And if we break in here, look, we can use one jump spell and get access right the way through the base. So that's what we're going to take advantage of. Queen is coming down, continuing to make the funnel, wizard creating a funnel here, and then we are going to press everything in. The king, again, he is a fantastic funneling troop. You might have seen it in a lot of these attacks that I've I've just shown you, basically just using the king sacrificially. You can then pop that ability, he can create the funnel so quickly, but in comes the Pekka smash. There they are, three Pekkas right up front, tanking for the bowlers. They're going to absorb some of that multi inferno fire, they're going to absorb the eagle artillery fire, and look at the troops from the clan castle trying to take down them Pekkas as well, but they're not good enough. They are essentially not good enough. We've got the queen there helping to shoot up towards that dragon, and look at the value that the bowlers get because they are a lot more protected. The Pekkas, whilst they don't have the same HP as a golem, they act very similar in that they will tank. But don't forget, the golem will only go for defenses, so it can quite easily get caught on walls, whereas the Pekka will never really do that because doesn't matter what's in there. Look at the storages. They will still go for the storages because they go for anything. But you can run into this problem, guys. What are they doing? They're trying to get back out of the base to get an army camp. I mean, come on. I guess it works out nicely. They split up. We have one Pekka at the top here. Two of them coming down to the bottom. Queen with the ability. So much damage. Celtic absolutely crushed this one. But there you are, guys. I hope that one does help you out. Showing you many different attack strategies at Town Hall 11. Six of the most popular right now in order to help you get the 3 stars. Now, if you are interested in seeing that attack video where we break down the LavaLoon, it is on your screen right now. And don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell, guys. But until next time, peace out.